did that show up like that?
Yeah, man.
Yeah, you need help.
The model of the car. Oh, okay, okay, okay.
Challenger, okay. Hellcat.
Oh, okay, okay.
On and drive to the next track, and
yes.
Then what you did.
Yeah, track.
Drag week.
Thank you.
in front of us, in front of me.
They're moving it too far.
Thank you.
check out those pictures. Just keep your head in the middle.
Combustion YouTube. Our channel is Internal Combustion. Internal Combustion.
All right, I'll subscribe.
All right, thanks.
Thank you.
Maybe later.
Tonight through tomorrow's, so help them out a little bit. I make these cars as accessible as possible this evening.
I just see all black, but
might need a. Could you clean them for us while you're down there?
Yeah. What kind of engine is this out of? What kind of engine is that out of?
Jetstars and the Sky Crane helicopter.
Okay, so the old
corporate airplane.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, they're all 50 years old plus.
Yeah. Okay. All right, cool. Thanks for bringing it to the show. I've never seen jet cars up in person. There's two of them here, so.
Yep. So he knows.
Thank you.
cars, Javelin. Is the 4-speed?
Yep.
Yes, it is.
It's a combo you probably don't see a whole lot.
No, not very often.
And then that is an AMC motor in there?
Yes, it is.
401?
Yep. It's an original motor.
Wow.
Full trains.
Okay.
I had the car for 47 years.
Ring Brothers did?
Yeah, I love that one.
Yeah, with the wheelbase stretched and,
yep.
and the Hellcat motor in it.
Yeah.
Now, was this a T-Tops car originally? Or could,
nope.
It looks like it.
This okay. is how it came factory.
Interesting. Right.
The AMX was the high performance model.
Yeah.
And the SST is the what they call a super sport touring.
Okay.
It had all the luxuries, you know, the corduroy seats, yeah. air conditioning, tinted windows from the factory. And then there was just the Javelin, which is the bare bones car.
Oh, okay.
You know, vinyl seats, usually automatic on the column.
Yeah.
You know, no comfort. I've had the car 47 years. It's my first car.
Really?
Yeah. I've had it since new.
When did AMC go under? I forget.
Mid-80s sometime. Yeah.
I think Jeep the last one? I know at least Chrysler inherited Jeep.
That I'm not real sure of. My dad worked at American Motors.
Oh, really?
And he was there right when they shut down the Milwaukee plant, and then they transferred him to Kenosha. And then he had to go for retirement from there. But yeah, that was in the mid-80s.
Before my time, I was born in 89.
Yeah.
I just know about the big three.
Yeah.
All right, sweet car. Good talking to you, man.
Thank you. You as well.
Yeah.
That's a nice camera you got there.
Thank you. Yeah, it's a rig that stabilizes it, so no matter here, you can try holding it.
No, that's fine.
But so even when I'm shaking and stuff, the camera stabilizes itself with these little motors here.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what do you do now with the pictures from the shows?
I put them on YouTube.
Do you?
Yeah.
Actually, this car is on YouTube.
Is it really?
If you Google 1,000 horsepower Javelin,
okay,
you'll see my car. Okay. I was out cruising one night and some guy was filming me.
Yeah, have you taken it to the track?
Yeah. It does mid to low tens.
Okay.
On street tires.
Okay, well, you consider this street tire, even though it's...
Yeah, that's
it's
a street
fair
tire.
Than, yeah. It's a Mickey Thompson, what is that?
They're called Super Sport.
Super Sport, okay.
The tires are... 18 and a half wide. It's a 15 inch rim and they are 31 inches tall.
Okay. So how do you launch this thing being a 4-speed? I mean, what RPM do you dump the clutch?
Just dump the clutch.
Do you really?
Oh yeah.
Oh man.
Oh yeah. You just kind of rev it up and I don't go by the tack or anything. I'm kind of like old school. I just listen to it. And
yeah.
When the R's are where I want them, I just wait for the light and let her go.
And then what, a couple seconds later, you're just looking at the sky?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, not quite that much, but
no? Okay.
Yeah, it's an adrenaline rush.
Yeah.
And I drive it almost daily in the summer.
Yeah, well, I'd imagine it does some pretty serious wheelies, though, being, you know, such a short wheelbase.
Well, on the street, it doesn't.
Not on the street, but on the track.
On the track, it does, yeah. That's why I got the wheelie bars.
Yeah, yeah.
But, yeah, I drive it a lot in the summertime. You know, if it's a nice day, I take the car.
Awesome.
I don't. It's not a trailer queen. I don't leave it sit in the garage under a cover. I drive it, and I drive it hard the way it was meant.
Yeah. Was it always white?
Yes.
Okay, I think I seen a gray one about 10 years ago that had a glow run it too.
So. Okay. Yeah, so but the way you see the car...
St. Charles, I don't know where you're from.
Milwaukee.
Milwaukee, okay. Yeah, so this is...
But it came with that interior. It's all the factory interior. It came with that blue vinyl roof. That was factory. The original color of the car is white. I just made it a little brighter.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's got like factory carpeting, you know, everything I tried to...
So can you tell me about the engine then? Can we go over there and look at it?
Sure.
All right.
Yeah, that's just that's the original motor.
So it's, I think, did AMC have like a big block and small block, or was it just all one?
No, it was yeah. all the same casting.
Yeah.
And you can't really tell by looking at them what size they are.
Yeah.
The only way you can tell the true motor is underneath the motor mounts, it's actually cast right into the block.
Okay.
If it's like a 343, a 360, a 390, or yeah. 401. So I naturally did some work to the motor. You know, I put aluminum heads on it.
Oh, really? Who makes those?
Edelbrock.
Okay.
And intake, it's a custom-made intake manifold for the blower, because it isn't something you can just buy off the shelf.
Yeah.
Not like for for a Ford or a Chevy. You know, you can go right to like to Hampton and order it, and they have it.
Yeah.
This had to be custom made.
So it looks like it almost sits on top of an intake manifold, right?
It is.
Okay.
It sits on top of an intake.
Is there any coolant, like intercooler that goes in there? Or no?
Well, just like a regular intake.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. Yeah, there is cooling ports.
Okay, I've seen the spacers before where it's, coolant's going.
But they have to, they take a regular intake and they got to cut the top off of it.
Yeah.
And then they weld what's called a plenum. Right underneath the blower, it's a big plate.
Yeah.
Then they have to weld that on there, and it gets all machined.
Right. Just then how much overhang this car has too, nothing past here does anything really. It's just,
It was just for
aesthetics or whatever.
Yeah. It's got a one-of-a-kind fiberglass hood.
Oh yeah?
You look at it, and a lot of people wouldn't think that it's fiberglass.
Yeah, I thought you just cut through the stocker to
No. There's a place here in Naperville that it's called Glass Tech.
Okay.
I brought them my steel hood, and then they took a mold of it, and then they made the fiberglass hood.
Yeah.
So it is the only one that I know of.
Okay.
Nobody's ever made another one. So it's kind of unique.
Well, it looks really good, because usually a fiberglass hood is just nice looking on the top. And underneath, you just see all the glass fibers exposed, and you can tell. Do you have hood pins for it too, or just the latch?
No. It's just the latch.
Okay.
I had to take the springs out of the hinges.
Yeah.
Otherwise, it's too hard on them. Yeah. And I also do have a pin on hood where it's just the shell, but I don't use that one at all. And they did such a perfect job, you can actually see the casting numbers, the numbers that was stamped in here from the factory.
Is that right there, in the middle?
Right here. There's a number right here that is stamped from the factory. It's really,
they did an excellent job. I said my camera doesn't want to focus on that, but
And it's, I put the stainless plates in here because actually under them you can't see the fiberglass marks. And they had to cut out some of this ribbing when they cut the hole for the blower. So, and I thought it would be a nice deal to put polished stainless steel on there like a mirror.
Yeah.
And it stays on there all the time.
Yeah.
It doesn't fall off or anything. Like I said, I tried to keep it all AMC that I could. It's got an AMC alternator, an AMC power steering pump, still got the AMC water pump, the brake boosters, the original AMC one.
Really?
Some stuff I had to change because of the upgrades.
Yeah.
I had to put a Wilwood master cylinder because I have four-wheel disc brakes now. The ignition system's electronic ignition now for the extra horsepower.
Okay.
On a chassis dyno, it's just under 1,000 horse. So it's a lot of fun.
And you're burning alcohol?
Nope.
100 octane or what?
I like to run 110 pump or race gas, but it's hard to find. So what I end up doing a lot of times, I gotta run just pump gas, and it had an octane boost to it.
And that works, huh?
It's okay.
Yeah.
It, but if I can, I try to find the race gas, and I have a 15-gallon cell, and then I'll put 10 gallons of pump gas, and then 5 gallons of race gas. And at like 760 or more a gallon for race gas, it can get pretty expensive.
Okay.
But if I can, I run straight race gas.
Have you ever thought about running methanol? Pull it down a little bit?
No. This car actually runs really nice.
Yeah.
In the heat and even in traffic, it never overheats. It runs so cool. Guys,
that's things for the electric fan or the radiator? Or
well,
what?
It's the combination of the radiator, the electric fan. And I was told an electric fan that pushes the air versus pulling it,
yeah.
You know, the fan being on the inside. This keeps it cooler. Plus, all the machining, you know, the engine builder did a phenomenal job on this motor.
Yeah.
It's a place called Don's Automotive in Kenosha.
Okay.
They really, really know their stuff.
Really?
Because I went to two previous engine builders, and they both screwed me.
Yeah.
The first one was called CNS up in Butler, Wisconsin. He took me for $12,000 and didn't stand behind anything. So then I went to another guy that I was recommended by for another $8,000. Same thing.
Oh, man.
So I went to Don's, and for right around $10,000, he built this, and he built it right.
Yeah.
And I drive it hard. I street race it all the time, and it's not a bit of problem with it.
So is it like the original crankshaft in there?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, they used the original crank and original rods.
Really?
Because the original stuff is a lot more stronger than the new stuff, you know, than the aftermarket. It's just the metallurgy back in the day was so much better.
Huh.
So they said, there's nothing wrong with it. Let's use your original crank, your original connecting rods. You put a bigger oil pan in it. Put an 8-quart pan, but other than that, you know, they did a little bit of machining on the inside of the motor, you know, because they had oiling problems at one time. So they took care of all that, and now there's no leaks on it. It just runs.
Yeah.
It's a big adrenaline rush. The drive.
Do a lot of people see this and ask what it is?
Yes, there's a lot of people. They think it's a Camaro a Charger or something like that.
Yeah.
But yeah, a lot of people, young people don't know what an AMC is.
Yeah. What's the visibility like? Is it hard to judge with the supercharger obstructing?
It's not too bad.
No? Okay.
You know, you just gotta, you look more forward.
Yeah.
You know, I ride motorcycle all the time too, so I'm used to looking way ahead.
Yeah, yeah.
You know. So if I need to, I can kind of go to the side and look around it, but usually it's, I've been stopped with this 3 times already, and they just want to see what it is.
Really?
They'll tell me, well, you know, the blower is illegal, you know, it's only supposed to be 2 inches out of the hood, and, you know, and the wheelie bars are illegal, and it is kind of loud, but they mostly want to just see what it is. You know, they see I'm an older person, so they figure, yeah, I'm not doing anything. But it's a lot of fun.
Yeah. So the 4-speed then, I mean, has that blown up on you before? Why do you have these ones out here? Are you
Well, I rebuild and restore four-speed transmissions.
Okay.
It's more of a hobby than a job.
Yeah.
When this David, when he retired, I worked with him for a long time, so I took on the business.
Okay.
That is just an old transmission. It's a cutaway. Kind of show the inside of the transmission and how it works.
Yeah.
And it's just another display, just, you know, what it looks like when it's not in a case.
Okay.
But I restore and rebuild them right back to factory. I use the factory hardware. I do all kinds of like concourse type transmissions.
Okay.
All numbers matching, all high end. Cool. We do all four speeds, no matter what brand they are, and we do shifters also.
Okay.
And I take a huge pride in what we do. So I just, you know, we're a small shop. But there's not many people doing this, rebuilding four speeds anymore.
Yeah.
And I'd like to think that there's nobody doing it as good as me, as far as the quality and how they look when we're done with them. You know, most people will, some won't even clean them up. They'll just rebuild them and say, okay, here you go. Other guys will clean them and they'll paint them, and then that's it. We don't paint any of ours. We do what's called a vibratory finish. So it gives it, like on this piece here, this has been vibratory finished. This is all the natural finish of the metal. It gets sandblasted.
Yeah, it's just aluminum right there.
Yeah, we sandblast it, and then we have we put it in a machine that's got like a ceramic media and a burnishing soap. And we run it in the machine for maybe an hour, and it polishes everything.
Okay.
So it's a higher end, you know, transmission. And I stand behind them.
Yeah.
That's so, that's a cluster gear.
Yeah.
That's the gear that goes in the bottom of the transmission.
And you said you use all stock OEM parts then, right? You know?
Well, as far as the case and the hardware is all, if they want that.
Yeah.
If it doesn't matter, we will put aftermarket hardware in the transmission. But they all get vibratory finish.
Okay.
Unless it's cast iron, then it gets painted with a cast coat paint, which is very durable.
Yeah.
As far as the gears go, the original gears, what's called the NOS gears, are hard to find.
Yeah.
So I get all my gears through a company that gets them from Italy.
Oh yeah?
The Italian gears are just phenomenal. They're excellent. So when I do these, I only put the best parts that I can find. I don't go cheap.
Yeah.
And that's why when I do these jobs, it's not a, I'm not cheap. And my prices aren't cheap either.
Yeah.
But if the customer wants something that they're gonna put in their, you know, like in their show cars and drive and never have a problem with, it takes money.
Yeah, yeah. So on a typical, this is a monthly four speed here, right?
Yep.
What's the weak link that you found when you rebuild these transmissions?
The second and the third gear are usually the ones that are in the worst shape.
Yeah.
The input is usually pretty good, and first gear is usually good.
So that's the second and third right here and here then?
Yeah, that's
okay.
The second and third. And then these are the synchro sliders. And I always replace these right away.
Okay, those are brass?
These aren't. These little brass rings, those are the synchro rings.
Oh, okay.
Those get replaced automatically.
Yeah.
And when I redo those sliders, if guys have an issue with it shifting, that's usually what it is.
Okay.
So what I'll do, I'll just go ahead and replace that with the Italian ones, yeah. which are the slider and a hub. It's like a machined fit. They fit really, really nice.
Yeah, they're tapered, right?
So, yeah, and they're made like together.
Okay, awesome.
If you buy the Asian sliders and everything, they look nice and they're cheaper, but they don't last long.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of issues with them.
I bet, yeah.
So when I started redoing these transmissions, David used to maybe reuse those if they were good yet. I don't even take the chance anymore. It's one of the parts in the rebuilds I just go ahead and replace.
Yeah.
Then it just eliminates everything, any problems down the road. Because if my name and my reputation is on it, I don't want any coming back except a repeat customer for something good.
Yeah. But, so do you ever put steel shift forks in or aftermarket shift forks? Is that a problem?
No.
Okay.
I don't use those at all. They have shift forks. They're the ones I put in are made in USA. They're called Crown.
Okay.
So they're machined really well.
Yeah.
They're, once again, that is some of the best stuff on the market.
Really?
Okay. You know, and for the cost of those forks, it's a cheap solution to any problems you would have.
Gotcha.
You know, that's one of the other things that I do replace when we rebuild them. So
is this a... the one in your car, then, is that a short gear ratio or a long gear ratio? Another way.
There's a wide and a close ratio.
Wide and close, yeah, that's what I meant. Yeah.
Mine is a wide gear ratio.
Okay.
The M20s are all wide gear ratios. The M21s are close ratio.
Yeah.
But what I have in mind is a BorgWarner T10.
Oh, okay.
And the Super T10s, those are all close ratio. But as far as the T10s go, and it depends, some are close, some are wide. It just depends on the gears. You know, what gears you want to run, so.
I've heard of terms like top loader and rock crusher.
Yeah, a rock crusher
yeah.
is an M22 Muncie.
Okay.
And the reason for that, why they call it a rock crusher, is because it winds.
Oh. These teeth are straighter.
Straighter, yeah.
Yeah, they're cut straighter.
Okay.
A Ford top loader is an excellent transmission.
Yeah.
But they call it a top loader because everything from the trans loads in through the top of the case.
Okay.
That's why it's a top loader. But Ford also does make a T10. So Ford made a T10, GM made a T10, and AMC made a T10. But they're all different.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's...
And we're not just talking about the bell housing, right? The internals are all different, too.
Yeah, the main shafts are different. Some of the Ford stuff is interchangeable with the AMC. But the GM T10s is totally different than the Ford and the AMC ones. And I also do the Mopar A833s. Those are some heavy duty transmissions there too.
Yeah.
They're all cast iron. They're pretty much indestructible.
What about the three on the tree? What kind of trans was that?
Well, it's just a three speed.
But it was a manual, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, that's what that was. Yeah. So
is that a Muncie product, or who made that, you know?
I think everybody did.
Oh, they did? Okay.
Yeah. I haven't seen a three-speed Muncie yet.
Yeah.
But the GM three-speeds are, they look totally different, you know. And then they made some three-speeds that were like in 57 Chevys, were in the mid-50s too, with had an automatic, or not a mod, electric overdrive.
Really?
Yeah.
Is that the Doug Nash transmission? Or no, that was later.
I think that came later.
Yeah, okay.
I'm still, some of the details and some of the stuff I'm
still learning yet.
Yeah.
But, you know, I've been doing this for quite a while, and there's stuff I need to learn all the time.
Yeah, okay. Well, you know, that's a cool business, and it looks like you do good work, and you have a good product to show it off. But, you know,
well, yeah, and that's why we're here, trying to promote the shop a little bit and have fun at the show and kind of relax.
Okay.
You know, we're a small shop. There's only four of us at the shop.
Yeah.
So we do some pretty long hours. It's fun to just relax.
So I take it you're David then?
Nope.
No.
My name is Mike.
You're Mike, okay.
David is the previous owner.
Oh.
And we decided when I took it over, I wasn't going to change anything. He's known worldwide.
Yeah.
And why fix something if it's not broke?
Right.
We kept the same phone number, the website, everything. All it is he retired and I just kind of stepped in and took everything over.
Okay. So where can we go to learn more about your products, Mike?
South Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Do you have a website or?
Yes, we do. It should be on one of those cards.
David's Ford Speeds.
Yep. You're more than welcome to take some cards with you.
Yeah, I will do.
And some flyers if you'd like. I mean, we do all this stuff.
Okay, so, good talking to you. Enjoy the rest of the show, guys.
You as well.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Uh-huh.
And then this is Troy.
Troy?
Troy.
Nice to meet you, man.
He's my right-hand guy.
There you go. Okay.
Yeah. Thanks.
Yep.
Don't forget our tune and gallery tomorrow, starting at noon until 10 p.m. on the second, the upper level. Our show tomorrow is at 10 a.m.
Put all brand new cylinders from the top.
Hey.
Hey, this guy just started this.
Yeah,
Michael.
Dan Michael. Sorry.
No, so
smoking
the
band
guys
were
running around.
No
lies.
Dead.
The guy that passed your son at car's door.
Spooky.
I gotta take my tablet back.
ain't got room.
I'm sorry, Jay.
Hey, Jay.
my ride.
I got a Jeep here that Dave uses.
It's like two sets on the core, right?
Is it even old?
The old graphics right there. Paint is dead. Just tell them.
Paint is dead.
He's gonna murder.
Late, probably next weekend.
Late, not
next
spray.
Weekend at Scott's basement, I'm murdered.
How long do those things last?
Thank you. Okay.